Hey everybody, Josh the RV Nerd here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan with the, we'll say 7,910-pound Catalina 323BHDS with a new updated interior, and I would love some feedback on what do you folks think about that. Catalina has had a lighter color decor, but I don't know that it necessarily worked with their exterior color palettes, and in really, I think that this is one of the first generations I've seen in a long time where the inside and the outside just really mesh nicely with one another. This thing has some serious curb appeal coming right off that nose. And this is an awesome family model with a private rear bunk room and second dedicated slide out plus big camp kitchen and bath direct entry door, which keeps a lot of foot traffic cut down on the RV. If you've never had an RV, you don't realize how much dirty foot traffic, especially the kids, are going to track in and out of the RV all day. One thing that's really interesting about this model is a little bit earlier, like about a month or so ago, I actually made a video talking about how it's very easy to convert a bunkhouse into an office. It was this model that I did that in. I showed you how for like $60 and zero screws or zero invasive work, this could be an awesome rolling mobile office or sewing room or craft room or dog kennel storage, all kinds of things. It's available with a second air, by the way, if you really want to make it an icebox back there. And I think the major thing they did with these interiors is they took a lot of that yellow tone out of the wood. It to some people, it looked very rich and warm. To some people, it looked and felt a little cheap and chintzy. This, to me, feels a lot more modern. And again, I think it meshes far, far better with the exterior tones. This has a 6'9" ceiling. You can see they gave you some maximized window coverage. Things like that extra skylight, which does have a power vent fan. We'll hit on that more in just a moment. The light color accents, like the very light countertops and the pretty light wall panels, and the new touch over into stainless appliances. It gives it, I think, a far more modern and just light-colored, welcoming look. And, you know, I wonder, what is underneath the stove right there? Some people, or the oven, some people use that for storage. I bet there's something like the water pump for winterizing. That would be a really good location for that. There's a bunch of little things that every brand does that makes them special. Like, one of the things I say in my videos all the time, and sometimes when people, they'll ask me, hey, Josh, could you compare this to that? And I don't like to offer comparisons to brands that we don't carry here because it feels very much like either I have to go way over the top or I'm attacking the other brand. You know what I mean? But little things like that, little things like just the little anchor for the big kitchen breeze through window right there. Things like just the extra kill switch for that 12 volt refrigerator. Most brands just don't do those little touches. Now, every brand has their own little touches. Like, I love that radius work on the kitchen cabinetry right there. Every brand has that one or two things that really make them special. And I think the total color package that we're looking at in these Catalinas is one of those things. Now, we have optioned this one. We like to do this on all the legacies wherever we can. There's only one or two models where it doesn't fit. That electric space heat and Tootsie Toaster right there. So whenever you're plugged into park power or a generator, basically, you have heat that doesn't eat up your propane. Now, when you're looking at this, a lot of people by default have already gone, oh, this is stupid. That is a Neckrecker Entertainment Center. That is terrible. Give me just a minute. I'm going to show you how that's not necessarily true. And we're going to do that as we start cracking everything open and looking at all the storage, beginning here with the sofa. And it starts right here under the sofa with like a giant storage chest. That is so handy, by the way, for like rainy day board games and stuff. And remember how I said that TV can pivot around for viewing from the slide. So like if you're over here at the sofa or dinette position where we're sitting currently, it's really not that bad. I think that this is a model, especially with that big camp kitchen, you're gonna wanna spend a lot of time outside. But every now and then it is really nice to be able to spend some time indoors. That electric fireplace again is something that we've added. And this is gonna sound crazy, maybe, but down below it, instead of that cabinet space with the double doors, I actually kind of wish that was just empty. I wish that was blank. And I know that sounds weird, but having a shoe garage right there in a bunk model like this that could potentially have a lot of different people with a lot of different shoes cruising through this thing, that would be really useful. Handy little things like a little separation on that upper drawer for your utensils is a nice little touch. And below the sink, you notice a shelf. Normally, I would say boy, it sure would be nice to have wastebasket space there, but Catalina thought of that. You know, you can't, from the front side, really get to that rear corner of the countertop, the storage below it, so they put a door there, which is perfect for wastebasket. And I tell you what, as somebody who camps, being able to open that door, being able just to reach around the corner and toss something in the wastebasket, that is so handy. Or that might not actually be a bad spot for like a, you could add a little pet door there, make like a little cat litter enclosure. Now with this camper being a little bit taller, they do something that Jayco and Wild would do a lot of here. They throw a shelf in that upper cabinet space. And something I want to show you here is one of the differences between stapled cabinet fasteners and screwed cabinet fasteners. This is wood, screws into wood here. So pocket screw cabinetry. You notice how everything is really fit and flush? When you screw the cabinetry together, it will suck those boards together and it really tends to create a more flush joint. Staple cabinet fasteners, they tend to hold up just fine. It's not that they're weak and going to fall apart. They just don't always look as pretty. They're not always executed as cleanly. They can be, just not always. Now up top here, they do give us like a combination skylight vent fan. You see that it is one of those smaller vent fans, but because the wiring and everything is already run, that is very easy. If you want to update and upgrade into a one of those larger vent fans, half the work's already done, effectively. Hang's Vortex fans are my personal favorite for doing that. They're less expensive. They work great. That is the 12-volt compressor fridge. Used to be optional, has since become standard. And I want to show you a little thing that I do every now and then here. So those covers over there for that big farm sink, which first of all is so big, you could bathe a baby in that thing if you needed to. But I swear RV designers are convinced that grease only flies backwards, not sideways. Well, that right there, in a way, kind of creates a makeshift side splash that is going to be very easily cleanable as compared to like a wooden wall panel. Now again, down below that big true U dinette, which can fold down into like a, basically about a 7 foot by 44 inch deep, I believe, sleeper, you have yourself, you know, full storage below that thing. And the one thing you haven't really seen so far is pantry space. And what's nice is we've got plenty of it here, but it's also sharing the wall with the, well, kind of the bathroom and the bunk room. So if you need to cannibalize a little bit of that at the bottom for dresser space, you'll see that you can. Although in a minute here, you're also going to see that the bunk room has some decent, not amazing, but decent storage itself. Now it's going to sound weird, but I actually think the bathroom is one of the better areas or qualities of this camper, and it's executed uncommonly. Now, let me get this out of the way. I'm actually going to jump around the corner here and stand, well, in the shower with you. That doesn't sound right. You know what I mean. There, for a person my size, there's plenty of leg room here. Everything fits fine. If you're a little bit wider than me, if you're a larger person, you may find that your left arm is too close to that wall right there. That's the kind of stuff I like to try to just smoke out and give you the information on that first and foremost. And, you know, if you like little extra tips and tidbits like that, hit the like button on our video or leave us a little comment that says, hey, thanks, Josh. You know, thanks for shooting me straight on that and being real about it. Also, it looks weird. There's this empty cutout over here. That is part of what makes the bathroom direct entry door literally physically possible. But the other thing that I thought about that is that would make, in a way, you could add some little coat hangers there. You could use that like a little jacket corner, a little coat corner, some place maybe for umbrellas or something. Or I mentioned in the living room, I'd like a shoe garage. Well, in a way, you've kind of got a nice little shoe corner there. You could add a couple little small shelves or something like that. Oops, I forgot to open that up. I'm sorry. Full storage down there, which is nice. Obviously, you've got some plumbing in the way, but they didn't waste it. And an easy step-in shower, not a tub. Some people like tubs. Some people like showers. This one does a shower. If you prefer a tub, give us a call. We got other things here at Halet RV. Now, with that taller ceiling, if you are bigger like me, you're going to be able to stand in that shower no sweat, which is a nice handy feature. Speaking of handy features, a sliding privacy door for the bunk room. And you have a shutting, why did I stress the T on that? Some shutting! I don't know what my deal is today. You have a real door for the bedroom is what I was going to say. But you can just be like on a rainy day, you'd be like, kids, go to your room. You're driving me and your mother crazy. With that booming dad voice that comes through to save the day. Although my wife has a pretty good booming dad voice too, which is good. She, you know, I love my daughter, but every now and then you got to get her attention. So they did a little thing here I don't know that I've ever seen another manufacturer do. Or maybe I've just never realized it. So you've seen bunk rooms like this where the bunk flips up. I call it a move bunk. Get out the way. But it's cool that it latches. And it latches on both sides. They're not just doing a single latch. But it can also latch and lock in the down position, which I found very interesting. And then I thought about it. My brother and I, if I was sleeping on that top bunk at one point in our camping lives together, my brother would have lifted that bunk and tried to smash me into the corner against that window that's up there. You know, being able to lock that down, it's not really a bad idea. And I need somebody to explain to me why these little convertible cube jobs right here, which I coincidentally call converted cubes, you know, not very creative, admittedly. They are one of the most flexible things I think I've ever seen. So, I mean, obviously, first of all, we've got it right here in the, daytime hangout lounge sofa position. But both of those lower things can flop out to create their own individual sleeper, plus the thing above. So you have like a king bed almost on the floor. You know, you could use one, you could use both, you could use whatever. You could totally empty this thing out to use it like an office. But obviously, the most critical feature is the Catalina Battlefort, which, I mean, boys, girls, ladies, gentlemen, if we're being honest, you're buying the camper for the Battlefort and you're just getting everything else, am I right? And remember, everybody, there's no age restriction on the Catalina Battlefort, nor is there really a size restriction back here. There's only a password required. So I ask you, what is the password? Anyway, now you have the option of building this RV with 50 amp service and adding a second air conditioner from the factory. This is the vent that gets prepped for the second AC, or the vent that gets cannibalized effectively if a second air is installed. And again, I think that, you know, remember how I just showed you how those beds could totally get out of the way? You could easily convert this into a very effective office space, I think, completely non-invasively. You could bring a table in here, you could turn it into a sewing room, a craft room. You could do all sorts of things like that without hammer, without nails, zero invasive work. So that when you're done with it, if you want to, you could convert it back into a bunk room and maintain full resale value without modifications. Or somebody could see they want an office and you've got one with an office. Looking at the storage in here, hanging storage in a bunk room like this is so, so uncommon. Plus in a little entertainment nook, below it rather, you've got a little bit of extra dresser storage space. That's where I say in this bunk room, has some decent storage. I'm not gonna say it's over the top, wow, but it's not bad. Look at that sliding privacy door there. And it is nice that on the ceiling, there is a switch for the main cabin lights. You can just shut off and be like, all right, kids, lights out. But these bunks each still maintain their own individual light. And you've got a double USB plug here that can be shared for the upper and lower beds to help keep all the different little devices going. But these are also next to the door space. So if you just need to reach around the corner, and say it's lights out time, night night kids, there you go. I tell you, the lighter colors in Catalina, their lighting is interesting. They never overdo it, but they never feel lacking in lighting inside their RVs. They what they kind of do is they build each floor plan. They say, okay, we're gonna put, you know, a light here, it looks dim over there, add a light there, add a light there. They add lights until they don't need to anymore. One thing they did change compared to last year was their entertainment setup. So we saw the TV can pivot out, but last year the TV was the stereo. It was the sound bar, and it had inside and outside speakers totally separately off the remote control. And that was neat, but the problem was it was not 12 volt. And a lot of people are liking to do a lot of boondocking stuff. Well, they went back to a more traditional 12-volt AM-FM Bluetooth stereo with an HDMI plug. So if you want to add things like a DVD or Blu-ray or gaming system or whatever, it's still capable of doing that, but at least the stereo can function off 12-volt. The TV's still 110. There's little inverters and stuff you could get to overcome that, though. Household and USB outlets on both sides of the bed. And they don't have really tall side stands. Actually, the side stands are the same height as the bed platform, which is nicer plywood, by the way, if you hadn't noticed there. What's kind of cool about that is if you wanted to go with a wider mattress or slide the mattress around so that you can make the bed more easily, it's a little simpler to do that. Now, in a Catalina Legacy, the Up Series Catalina that we're in, you'll have a full overhead cabinet. In a Summit, you'll have just a shelf, basically. What else was I going to show you in here? Oh, I was going to mention, kind of like where I mentioned where the bathroom wall could be a little tight for you. This is a camp queen. It's a big camper. They didn't want to make it longer than they had to. Catalina basically just pretty much always uses camp queens. You could squeeze a true queen in there. You're going to give up a little bit of walk around room. Now we saw, actually, no, you haven't seen it yet. Sometimes I record these bits out of order. Well, I've just screwed myself up, so what I'm about to say, I'm going to say it like it's the first time I've ever said it, but I don't feel like reshooting this video segment. There's a handy switch just right here on the wall, which is cool, because that can be hard to reach. Those right above the bed are on a set there on their own individual click switches, kind of like we saw in the bunk room, because they're easy to reach. Now, when we flip around the other direction in the bedroom, you don't see much. Like, there's TV hookups on that wall, but that is also a big blank wall. You want to put yourself a big old jumbotron in this bedroom, you could do that. One other thing I like to point out, it's a tiny thing, but this being a little bit taller in the ceiling than the statistical historical average of travel trailers, well, it is nice that it just has a light switch up there. So that someone who's a little bit more gravity friendly, like say the missus of my household, well, you know, she could get in here. Now, I always like to try to close up slides on things and show how they're going to look in road mode. And this one, if you need to walk through here, you need to make a travel sandwich stop. This is sandwich stop compliant because we can get to the kitchen. We can get to the refrigerator. You know, you can you could make a bite to eat, but unless you got teeny tiny little kids and you're going to pick them up and drop them like a tea bag back past that slide fascia, you do need to open the slide on this one. This is definitely a model that's made for getting there and setting up shop for some time. But remember, because we do have that second entry door over here, if need be, you can still make a travel and potty stop without needing to deploy any of the slides. I suppose you can make a shower and stop. I don't think a lot of people would do that, but I don't know. Maybe. Does anybody take like long trips, need RV shower and stops? Leave me a comment on that. I never really thought about it. And man, I'll give them credit. On this Legacy series, that like electric blue accent they have on the nose. Oh my good gravy. To me, that looks good. But I mean, that's just my opinion. What do you guys think? I think that just looks absolutely stellar right there. Now up front, a couple cool things. Let's just start right from the front, work our way around. We've got the power tongue jack doing the heavy lifting for us. And back here by the double battery capable tray, your first battery, by the way, included at no additional charge from us at Haylet RV, you've got a battery disconnect switch. Now remember, that 12 volt fridge has its own kill switch. So this gives you multiple ways of making sure that you're not going to accidentally murder the batteries while the RV is in storage. People do not realize how much, it's called parasitic load, how much passive drain exists on the batteries of RVs nowadays. That just didn't used to happen. RVs didn't used to have all these various computer boards and circuit panels in them. Nicely sized front pass-through as well. We've got this one outfitted with those handy stable steps right there with the adjustable legs. And that is an anti-slam entry door, by the way, so it doesn't go whacking against the sidewall of the RV. One of the things I really like on this one, though, is that both of the entry doors are nicely covered by the awning, especially that front door. But if the wind catches them, they can't accidentally hit the awning arms, which is a really good way of screwing up a RV's awning. We do have outside TV hookups over here, and this is like the perfect place, I think, if you're gonna add a little picnic table. But one of my favorite things on Catalina's, it's such a small thing, but to me it's a big thing because I've assisted clients through a parts and service process before, and that is these metallic fender flares right here instead of plastic. It doesn't sound like a major ordeal, but if you've ever had to try to find and replace a couple year old version of a fender flare, plastic fender flare, it's tough. It's expensive, way more expensive than you would think. Those metallic flares right there, man, they don't fail unless you run into them with a lawnmower. I say that all the time. Again, we got that direct entry bathroom right here, which along with the outside fridge that we're gonna see in just a second, seriously cuts down on the total amount of dirty foot traffic coming in through the camper. And this has a large camp kitchen. And one of the other things I really like about this, like when we start looking at the camp kitchen, we look at the fridge, we look at that griddle, we look at the sink, that's cool. I think one of the unsung qualities on this one is the fact that it actually has
a positive latch system. It helps this big door latch properly so you don't accidentally get water leaking through there. And here's one other thing that I kind of like about this. We've got a big patio awning on this, but this door is high enough, even at my size. You saw me stay in the shower. This is very comfortable to walk under. Now, I'm not going to jump. I did that on a previous Catalina tour. I didn't realize I could actually jump that high, and I did clock my noggin on that thing, and I don't feel like doing that again. Funny, you would think somebody would want to just keep repeating that, right? We got our drunken Uncle Leash latch over here, because if Uncle Josh gets within earshot of a barley pop opening, I'm about two sheets to the wind. I am super lightweight. I'm also a cheap date, although, you know, my wife doesn't have to worry about that anymore. The griddle here, it's like a lot of our, this is the same griddle that say like Rockwood and Freedom Express use. It's a good system. What I like about it is that it locks in place. You have to use two hands to open or close it, so it can't accidentally fly open and bang against the inside of the door in transit, or one of the kids wheeling around the corner can't accidentally bump it, cause it to fly shut inside that heat shielding in there and knock whatever's on here off of here. You just don't have that concern. We have the same sealed edge counters here, a full real sink, not the dump sink, not the dog dish, and just to help you get into them barley pops, we got the 37 series bottle opener over there and some good storage outside. See, I've really noticed a full-size camp kitchen like this has become about as rare as hen's teeth. They're about as rare as hair on a frog. I could keep going, I will stop. You get the idea. It's like everything's a small camp kitchen nowadays. There's not a lot of big camp kitchens anymore. I like the big camp kitchen. I like the bigger fridge and stuff out there. I like the headroom and the shade on my head while I'm cooking, you know. We are, so this is a walkable roof. They don't offer a factory ladder, nor do they have studs in the wall to add a ladder. That has become weirdly common within this classification of RV. I don't know why the sudden trend toward that. I would prefer a ladder, but there's not one capable, and I would rather just get that right out of the way so that you know what's what and you know, you can plan accordingly. I really do like the cargo rack on the back here. So that has about a 200-pound capacity, by the way. That's before the spare tire, which is optional. We option on that spare tire so that you don't have to worry about it. It just boggles my mind that spare tires are optional in today's market. It also, something I like to point out on these Catalinas, a couple things right here. The windows are all tinted to help keep the sunshine out, and their outside showers can actually be used to shower outside. And I know that sounds stupid when I say it, but most manufacturers don't mount that cleat right there for their outside showers. They mount it in the outside shower door. They leave it right there. Catalina takes that off and puts it up here where you could actually use the thing. A couple other key points. Their slide outs have this really rough texture on them so that it really grabs those slide wiper seals. And you'll see that this is a triple sealed slide system. We've got wiper one, wiper two, and bulb inside or outside. So there's always three points of contact helping keep water out of those slide outs there. Now, the underbelly of these, they are all standard on the Legacy series. They're all enclosed. On the Summit series, which is the little bit simpler series, the underbelly enclosure will be optional. You'll find that we tend to do that about 10 times out of 10 here at Haylet RV, though. You may have noticed how those like front baggage doors have a magnet hold back on them, and that wraps us right back around to the front here, where I think we've pretty much covered everything, but I gotta take just a second to let the sunshine gleam off that thing, because, oh my Lord, maybe it's just because I was born in the 80s, and when I was in, you know, third grade or whatever, neon colors were the coolest thing in the world, man. But wow, that blue gets me every time. Everything out there, it's so brown or just so white and black. Every now and then, just that little kiss of color really does it for me. So how would you guys use this one? Conventional family bunkhouse, I think that's probably going to be the bulk of the answers, but do you think this would make a good office space? Would you look at something like this? Like, would you personally have need to convert this from a bunk room into something else like we've discussed? I'd love to know. Leave us some feedback. And what do you think about the new decor? I think it looks good. It's subtle. It's not a major shift from what they were doing, But it looks good, right? I'm a fan. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and until next time, everyone.